Hi everybody, Carol here. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to be making a waterfall card, and this is a pumpkin waterfall card. And I'm starting off by having to sketch off a pumpkin because I didn't have anything that would work the right size and everything else. So I just sketched one onto a piece of copy paper, and I'm cutting it out to make a template. Then I also traced over that center section of the pumpkin and the stem, and cutting them out to be templates also. Now I'm tracing around these pumpkins, two white ones, with the template, and I'm also going around that center section to show the dimension of the pumpkin, and going around the stems. And I'll cut all these out. You will see I'm going to go back onto the stem and use a white jelly roll pen after I erase the pencil marks, and just add a little highlights onto that little blob of green so that you tell more what it is. And then I take the Millennium pen and draw around that center section of the pumpkin so that that will stand out, rather than just leave it in pencil. So I will have to cut these out. I will cut out two white ones, and you won't see me cut them out, but later you will see I have two more pumpkins, and they are purple. I decided to go with white and purple on this. And I'm erasing the lines. Now these are my measurements. The long strip of paper in the middle is what makes it all work. And that strip is 2¼ by 10¾. I'm showing with my pencil up there the correct one. I had originally written 11 and that was wrong. 2¼-inch squares, four of them. A strip that is also wrong, 1 inch by 7. It's a 5x7 card, but I'm going across the width of the 5-inch part of the card, so I should have said 1x5, but you'll see that it'll be obvious when I start putting it together. Now I fold this card not directly in the middle, this long strip, and I'm showing with that black square there. You can see there's a little overhang of 1/4 inch. I fold it at the 5¼-inch mark on one side and 5½ on the other. Now once it's folded, just on one half of it, I'm going to mark 1-inch segments. And I'm going to line these little squares up 1 inch higher than the other. I only had three, so I'm taking the fourth one out to show you that's what it would look like all together. I'm going to take my Tombow Mono Multi Glue and go around each little rectangle separately 1 inch, you know, about the 2¼-inch width. And what I didn't show you right now, but I will in just a little while, is those 1-inch sections also need to be scored and folded. And you will see why. Now this long strip here is 1/4 inch wide by 6 inch all the way down to the tip of the arrow, which of course the arrow is wider than 1/4 inch. But you could write any message on there you wanted to. On some of them I wrote "Happy Fall, y'all." You could say "I love you, have a great fall," anything you wanted to, or "Love mom or grandmom," whatever you want to write. Now I'm starting with the 5x7 piece of orange paper, putting down some pattern paper, which is about 4¼ inches wide. You could make it really any length or width you want to, whatever pleases your eye. And then this strip, this black strip I was talking about, that's 1x5, I'm poking some holes in the end, or punching with a 1/16-inch hole punch. And actually I'm making two little punches so that it'll be bigger than 1/16 of an inch. And I bent it over to line it up with the other side to try to get them centered, and you can certainly measure if you want to, or eyeball it if you trust yourself, and then take your pencil and mark through those holes and go back and punch some more holes into the orange paper. Now when you line them up, line the holes up, you take some brads. I have little bitty brads because I like them. And these are yellow, and poke them through, and I just use the ruler to mash that down flat. Use what you have. I'm pushing that just a hair to just give you a little bit of slack. I don't know that you have to do that, but something's going to be sliding back behind that, and I wanted to be sure it wasn't too tight of a fit. Now that is the background of the base card. And here are the pieces. There you'll see the two purple pumpkins. You can see where I glued the stems on top of the pumpkins. Now this is where I'm showing that I scored that as well and folded it up, and that's what makes the waterfall work. So we bring in the pumpkins. This one is already glued to its black square. It can hang off a little bit on either side, but not much, in order for them not to get intertangled with each other, and tangled up, I should say. And so you put the bottom one down first, and I'm staggering them white, purple, white, purple. The next one goes to that 1-inch score, and that of course is where it is also glued. The next one goes to the next 1-inch score, and then the last one, I decide to fold the card down to be sure I'm lining it up properly at the top. Then you can give them all a good mash, a good burnish, be sure they're all stuck. And it is done. Now this is where you pull in your little arrow and glue it on where the arrow is sticking out, you know, 1/4 of an inch, whatever looks good on your setup. And I chose to write the word pull down on that arrow, so there would be no guessing as to what you do with this card. And I also write a little instruction sheet I'll show you at the end of the video. So I'm lining it up, the top of the pumpkins with the top of the pattern paper, trying to center it. And I'm going to go back with a pencil and just make some little marks as to where that 2.5 inch, or 2 1/4 inch, I should say, strip, try to get it centered. I'll pull that back off and put some glue. This is the only glue that you'll have on those pumpkins and on the waterfall, because they need to move freely. But they also need to be attached, of course. So this is where the attachment comes in. And the little strip keeps them from going too far, or it also gives you the ability to slide those pumpkins. Okay, so now it's time to put it all together. There's the background paper. Here comes the waterfall. You put the underneath part of that strip down under the black strip. Line it up. And we're getting that bottom pumpkin and its square to glue down to the black strip. Here we go. Here's the pool. Each one of those pops up, except the last one. It is stationary. It is glued down. Happy fall. And then you push it right back up. And there is that cute, cute concept. I got this idea from Sandy Genovese. I'll give her all the credit. There are a lot of waterfall cards out there for sure, but she's the first one I saw. So here we go. One more time. I'm pulling it slowly so that you can see how it works. And I just think it is a really, as the expression goes, a lot of bang for your buck. Now there is the original one I made after I saw Sandy's video, and I'm not sure it's still up, and I'm not sure how long ago that was, but mine is orange. It's not exactly like hers, but orange. I decided to put the yellow down the middle. And so there they are, side by side. Gonna do that really fast just for fun. Happy fall, y'all. And then there is a little note that I put in mine. It says, this is a waterfall card. Pull the pull tab down and the waterfall comes down. Push the tab back up and the waterfall closes. Just in case you need someone, think someone needs to know how to work it. Thank you for joining me. Have a great day. Bye-bye.